Good morning. Now we will discuss the part two of the principal sources of optimization. Here you are having the two types of optimization, local optimization and global optimization. Here you are having the some of the function preserving transformations. What is function preserving transformation means? You can perform the transformations, that is you can change the statements, but that should not affect the functions. See, you can have four types: common sub-expression elimination, copy propagation, dead code elimination, loop optimization. See here, in part one, we have already seen how to convert your three address statements into the flow graph. We are having six blocks. Here you can take the block five. Here you are going to perform the common sub-expression elimination, that is local optimization. See here, you are having 2, 4, 6, 8 plus 9 statements that should be reduced into 7 statements here by applying the common sub-expression elimination. See here, you are having 2, 4 into i, 4 into i. Similarly, you are having 4 star j, 4 star j. So these two 4 star j's are common expressions. These two 4 star i is common expressions. During the identification of common sub expressions, you have to check the values of that, whether it is changed or not. See here, 4 into i is multiplied and assigned to its p6. That is the location of the array. So FT6 assigned to x. Next, again you are having the 4 star I. Here you are not changing the any I value. It's 4 that is similarly. Here also you are not changing any I value. Here J value is not updated. So you can have the two common sub expressions here. That is 2 4 star I and 2 4 star J. So you have to eliminate this. So you have to eliminate one. You have to keep one statement as the optimized statement. See here, T6 and T7, you eliminate T7. Wherever you are having the T7, that should be replaced by the statement T6. You see here, you can eliminate T7 statement. So T7 is eliminated here. Next, here you are having the T7. That should be replaced by T6. So here, A of T7 equal to T9. Here you replace T7 by T6. So you can get A of T6 equal to T9. Next, you are having 4 star J, T8 and T10. So you eliminate T10. Wherever you are having the T10, there you replace T10 by T8. Because T10 and T8 have the common sub expressions. So T10 is replaced by T8. So TF T10 equal to X. So F T8 equal to X. So here, statement T7 equal to 4 star I is eliminated. Statement T10 equal to 4 star J is eliminated. Where T10 is replaced by T8. T7 is replaced by T6. After that, we are having this result. Here you are having 3, 6, 9 statements. Here you are having 7 statements. That is T8 and T10 is eliminated. This is called local optimization. Next, you have to perform the global optimization. This slide explains how the common sub expressions are eliminated within the block. That is called local optimization. Next, we are going to see about how to eliminate the common sub expressions between the blocks. That is called global optimization. See, we can compare the table B5. You can consider the table B5. Here, you can take B2. You compare B2 and B5. B2, you are having the statement P2 equal to 4 star i. Similarly, B5 you are also having the statement P6 equal to 4 star I. So you are having the two common sub expressions here. This T2 is assigned to T3, then you are not having the any I statements. So here values are not updated, that is I value is same in both the places. So you have to eliminate T6. Instead of T6, you have to replace T2. A of T2 is assigned to T3. See here, T6 is eliminated. Instead of T6, you are replacing T2. So you will get it's equal to A of T2. You already know A of T2 is assigned to T3. So we are replacing H is equal to T3. So you can get H is equal to T3. Next, we are having the T8, that is equal to 4 star J. Here, block B3, we are having T4 equal to 4 star J. Now, we are having the common sub expressions between the block B3 and B5. So, now you have to eliminate the statement T8. Wherever you are having the T8, that should be replaced by T4. So, here you are having T8. So, that is equal to A of T4. A of T4 is assigned to T5. So, T5 is assigned to T9. That T9 is assigned to A of T6. So, instead of T9, you are having the T5. Instead of T9, you are having the T5. Similarly, instead of T6, you are having the T2. So, you are having A of T2 equal to T5. Next, A of T8 equal to its. T8 is eliminated. Instead of that, T4 is replaced. See here. T8 is eliminated, T4 is replaced, T4. So you are having the A of T4 equal to H. So A of T4 equal to H, go to B2. So here you are having the 7 statements between the global optimization between the block eliminates 7 statements into, reduce 7 statements into 4 statements. This is called global common sub expression elimination. The same thing will be done for between the block B6. We have seen in part 1 block B6 and B3. We will get these 4 statements. This is called common global sub expression elimination. Next, we are having the copy propagation and dead code elimination. Before that, you are having the strength reduction. What is strength reduction means? You have to eliminate the variables. That is, you have to move the variables that is not needed here. For example, see here, we are having the statement T2 equal to 4 star. Strength reduction is the last state phase. Here you have to perform the copy propagation and dead code elimination in between the blocks 5 and 6. First, copy propagation. What is copy propagation means? You are assigning the one statement into the another statement. That is, you are copying one statement into the another statement. See here. In this statement, in this slide, you are having T4 equal to 4 into J. J equal to J minus 1. Now you assume j value is 3. So 3 minus 1 equal to 2. 4 into 2 equal to 8. So now t4 value is what? 8. Now you decrement j by 1. Now j becomes the 2. 2 minus 1 is 1. So next you multiply 1 by 4. That is 4. First you are having the 8. Next you are having the 4. So the difference between these two statements is 4. So here multiplication operation is cast more tasks compared to the subtraction operation. So here reduce the task by replacing the multiplication operation by subtraction operation. That is called strength reduction. So here you are replacing 4 into j. Each and every time this loop is executed, this value is reduced by 4. So here you are writing t of 4 equal to t4 minus 4. T4 equal to t4 minus 4. Because when we explained j value is 3, then it becomes the 2. Then again, an extra decrement, j value becomes the 1. That is 2 minus 1, 1. So first time you are having the 8, second time you are having the 4. So same value is received by replacing the multiplication operation by subtraction operation. So here t4 equal to t4 minus 4. This is called a strength reduction. So similarly, you can perform the strength reduction here also. See here, I equal to I plus 1, t2 equal to 4 star I. Here your I value is 4. 4 plus 1 is 5. So 5 into 4 is 20. Next, you can increment the I by 1. 5 will be incremented by 6. 6 into 4 is 24. So previous you are having 20. Next, you are having the 24. Next, you are having the 28. Then you are having the 32. So the value is incremented by 4. So you can replace this multiplication operation by addition operation. So you can write replace t2 equal to t2 plus 4. So after strength reduction in this block, t2 becomes t2 plus 4, t4 becomes t4 minus 4. But here, I equal to I plus 1, this I value, here j equal to j minus 1, but the j value is not used in this block, in some other places. So you have to remove this. So you can remove this. Similarly, in this statement also, I plus I, after replacing t2 equal to t2 plus 4, this I will not be used in this block. So you have to remove this. But before that, before process coming these two blocks, here you need the reference of I, because here you are having the I greater than or equal to j. So you are moving t2 equal to 4 star I and t4 equal to 4 star j into the outer block. So t2 equal to 4 star I, t4 equal to 4 star j is moved to the outer block. So here, what are all the optimizations you have done? When I value is incremented by 1, this will be incremented by 4. So you are replacing the statement t2 equal to t2 plus 4. That is multiplication cost operation is reduced by replacing the multiplication cost is reduced by replacing the multiplication operation by subtraction operation. See here, t4 equal to here also. T4 into j is replaced by t4 minus 4. Next, after replacing the addition operation and subtraction operation, the I and the j value is no longer used within the block. So you can remove that. But you need the reference for this I and j. So you are moving this 4 into I, 4 into j into the outer block. So that these two values are moved here. This is called strength reduction. Next, you are having the dead code elimination, then copy propagation. See here, x is equal to t3, A of T2 equal to T5, A of T4 equal to X. Here, X equal to T3, T3 is assigned to X, then X will be assigned to T4. See, doing these two process, directly you can assign the X value into the T4. So, that statement will be removed. X will be removed. Instead of X, T3 will be assigned. So, A of T7 equal to T5. Sorry, F T2 equal to T5, then F T4 equal to T3. Go to B2. Sorry, these two statements are here. You should have T2 and T4. Here you are having the T11 and T2 and 40. So you check the blots, but decode elimination is like this. It's here I greater than or equal to J is replaced by T2 greater than or equal to T4. That is, see here, T2 and T4. Whenever I value incremented by 1, your values will be incremented in terms of 4. Similarly, J value is also incremented in terms of 4. So, I greater than or J is equivalent to T2 greater than T4. I is 1, J is 1 means 4 greater than 4. I is 2, J is 1 means 8 greater than 4. So value will not be changed. So instead of I and J, can replace T2 and T4. This is called decode elimination, copy propagation. So suppose if you are not having any clear idea about this problem, next we will give the visualized presentation. That is, you are having the quicksort algorithm. Then that will be converted into three address statements. Then you are transferring the control flow graph. You already know how to transfer the control flow graph. After that, you need to eliminate the common sub-expressions. That is, you have eliminated. You can get this. Then again, you are applying the global common sub-expressions. You will get this. Then you are having the topic propagation. That is X of T3. So T3 is eliminated. X is eliminated. Instead of that, T3 is assigned. Next, you are having the loop optimizations. Loop optimization is done in three ways. That is code motion, index variable elimination, reduction in strength. See here, loop optimization is very, very important because running time is increased when you are having the more number of statements in the loop. So you decrease the number of statements in an inner loop and increase the number of statements in the outer loop, because inner loop is executed in many number of times. So same statements is executed in many times, the running time is more. So try to apply the loop optimization, and that will reduce the number of statements in the inner loop. Next, you are having the code motion. What is code motion mean? It moves the code outside of a loop. You see here, while I less than or equal to limit minus 2, each and every time this loop is executed, the 2 will be subtracted from the limits. So instead of that, you can have the one temporary variable t that will subtract 2 from the limit. That is, limit minus 2 is assigned to t. Next, you are checking I less than or equal to t. Here you are having only one subtraction operation. Every time the loop is executed, that is compared with the result value, that is limit minus 2. Not every time the subtraction is done in the loop. This is called code motion. That is, you are having the operations here within the while loop that should be moved out of the loop. That should be assigned to one temporary variable. That temporary variable is checked in the while loop. This is called code motion. Next, induction variable elimination. And you already seen how to eliminate the blot 3. J and T4 are induction variables, that is eliminated. Next, reduction in strength, you also know. Here you are replacing the more expensive operation by the less expensive one. That is, multiplication operation is replaced by addition or subtraction operations. After loop optimization, you are having the final code. See, now we will give the virtualized representation for this. See here, this is three other statements. First, you have to identify the leaders. You already know the first statement is a leader. Then go to of 5, conditional dot is a leader. The immediate statement to the conditional or unconditional dot is a leader. Here you are having the go to 9 is a leader. The immediate statement to this conditional go to is a leader. So immediate statement to this conditional go to is a leader. Then 20 go to 23, that is a leader. Then it go to 5. So 5 is a leader. So now you identified the leaders. Then you constructed the basic blocks. That is block 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Then you are having the connections. This is called a control flow graph. Here you have to eliminate the common sub-expression elimination. First, you perform the local optimization. That should be done within the block. See here, T7 equal to 4 star I. Then T10 equal to 4 star I, 4 star J. So you are having the 2 J operations, 2 I operations. So that will be replaced. That is E of T6, 4 star I is removed. So T6, 4 star J is removed, that is T9. Similarly, you do this block also, 4 star I, 4 star M. You eliminate T15, then you are having the T11 and T30. This is local common sub-expression elimination. Next, you are having the global sub-expression elimination. Here 4 star I. Here also 4 star I. Here you are having the 4 star I in the block B2 and B5. So here you are performing the between the blocks. So this comes under the global sub-expression elimination. So T6 is eliminated. Instead of T6, T2 is replaced. So instead of T6, T2 is replaced. Similarly for B6. Next, you are having the dip code elimination. Here you are having x is equal to T3, x is equal to T3. So here x is assigned to, in here T3 is assigned to x, then x is assigned to T4. So instead of two statements, you can eliminate this one directly, it can have the T3. So T3, similarly you are having the T14. Next, reduction in strength. Here you are having the I equal to I plus 1. T2 equal to 4 star Y. So here you are having the increment by 4. Here you are having the decrement by 4. So you can replace T2 equal to T2 plus 4, T2 equal to T2 minus 4. But next I is not going to be used within this block. But here you are having the I and J. So you have to move these two, T2 and T4 values are moved into here. That is for reference. In this loop, you can have the many number of multiplication operations whenever loop is incremented. But when it is moved to the out, here only once these two operations are performed. This is called reduction in strength. That's all about principal sources of optimization. So we have seen how to solve the particular algorithm is given. How to optimize the particular algorithm is given. So in this topic, we have taken QuickSort as the example. First, we converted our QuickSort algorithm into three address statements. Then, based on the three rules, you have to identify the leaders. Then you have to construct the basic blocks. Then you have to find the flow graph based on the conditions. After constructing the flow graph, then you have to apply the optimizations. You are having different ways to apply the optimization, common sub-expression elimination, reduction in strength, loop optimization, and have various ways to optimize the code. So finally, you will get the optimized code. Thank you.